What was that? Hey there, everybody. What's going on? Welcome to this week's episode of Thungry Thursday. We got a special summertime treat for you. I don't know why I'm looking up there. Still trying to get used to this new camera. If you haven't checked that out already, look at my previous videos. So, special summertime treat. We got the 4th of July weekend coming up. So I figured I'd do red, white, and blue dessert. So why don't you come with me and Amanda as we go outside and get some rhubarb. Hey, don't you know?
In the back or the front?
Maybe a little both. Yeah, because I got rhubarb growing in two different spots in the backyard. So the trusty dusty rhubarb cutter. Yeah. Like a raptor's claw. Cut you maybe across the gut. Yeah, this year didn't really lay out the garden too good. I mean, it's great, it's working so far, but it was worse last year. But each year is going to be an improvement. Yeah, one stick of rhubarb. Put that right there. If you're wondering what I save these for, all the tops of them, it's because they're actually poisonous. So what I do is I like to lay them down in between my tomato plants as a preventative for bugs. Just drop them in there. All right, we got our rhubarb, got the knife. We're gonna need a little more than that, so come with me to the other garden. Amanda's gonna cut up the rhubarb for us. A couple pieces are dead here.
This one's small.
Yeah. Because this is the one that we grabbed from the last time.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so you're going to want to start off and wash those rhubarb down, wash your strawberries down. I don't use pesticides in my garden, but I want to make sure to get all the bugs and anything else off them. Next up, you're going to want to cut your rhubarb. I like to cut them into like quarter inch slices. You don't really need to be any, you know, perfect measurements with these because they actually do shrink down a little bit when they cook. Next up, you're going to want to cut the tops off your strawberries there. It's going to make it a lot easier when you actually have to cut the strawberries up themselves. Once again, there's no perfect way to cut the strawberries. I just like to cut them up into quarters. And then if they're really big, cut them right in the middle again. Once you're done cutting, grab your dry ingredients. You're going to need oats, brown sugar, flour, butter, and vanilla extract. Go ahead, take your butter right now. Might as well stick it in the microwave. You're going to want 1/2 cup of melted butter. My trick is I put it in the microwave for 20 seconds at a time, take it out, mix it, put it back in for 20 seconds, and I like to do this until it's all melted, depending on how much butter I need. I've had the trouble where the butter's overboiled inside the microwave and everything. Try not to make a mess. Start off with 3/4 cup of flour. Next up, add 1/2 cup of light brown sugar. If it's got any clumps in it, you're going to want to take those clumps out. We're going to add our 3/4 cup of flour into a mixing bowl along with 1/3 cup of oats and add that 1/2 cup of brown sugar in there. Once again, if there's any clumps, just break them out real quick. It makes it a lot easier. Then you're going to want to add your 1/2 cup of melted butter. Don't forget 1/2 teaspoon vanilla extract. Mix it up real nice. Once you're done mixing, you're going to want to throw that into the freezer for 5 to 10 minutes. You're going to see why. Now go and grab your fresh vegetables that you just washed, dump them into another mixing container. So you should have about a cup of strawberries and a cup of rhubarb. Then you're going to add 1/3 of a cup of sugar to it and sprinkle it on top. The sugar actually takes the bitterness away from the rhubarb. If you don't like rhubarb, add more sugar. If you like the bitterness of it, leave less out. Then you're going to want to add some flour into there, half of a cup exactly, and mix it up real, real good. Once you got yourself a good mix going on, dump it into a nice bowl that you're going to want to cook this in the oven. Spread that sweet, sweet goodness evenly all over the bottom. And at this point, might as well go over and preheat your oven. Do it for 350 degrees just to start for the preheating process. And then we're going to bring it on up when we put the dish in. Now taking your topping mix out of the freezer there, it should have stiffened up a little bit and it's going to make it a little bit easier for you to put on top. And all you're going to do is just scoop some out and you're going to see it's going to actually spread itself evenly across. And if it doesn't, you know, give it a hand there. All this wonderful topping is going to turn nice, crisp, and golden brown, and it's going to be tasty and delectable the second it starts cooking in the oven. So, like I said, just give it a little hand, make sure it's even. If you're just going to be eating this yourself, don't worry about it. No matter how it looks, it's going to be amazing. And if you're bringing it to a party or something, spend that extra minute and just make sure, you know, it's a tip-top shape. Next up, you're going to want to pop that bad boy in the oven and bring the temperature up to 375 degrees. Set yourself a timer for 45 minutes. Doesn't mean run away for 45 minutes and then it's instantly done. Every oven cooks differently. Make sure to keep an eye on it because you don't want to ruin this. Nature's bounty. Mother Earth spent so long growing these vegetables for you. You might as well do them justice. Oh my God, it's 14 minutes left. I can't even emphasize how good this smells. Check it out. Oh my God, I can't wait to eat that. Whew, it's warm in there. Turn that off, turn that off. Okay, big thank you to Amanda for helping me out today. She did an awesome job, and I can't wait to try it. But right now, drop a comment down below if you like the video and if you want to try the recipe. Let me know how it turns out. It's a great treat for 4th of July weekend, which is coming up this weekend. So that's why I did the episode. But yeah, once again, thank you, Amanda. And
you're welcome.
Have a good weekend, guys. I'll be seeing you tomorrow for Free For All Friday.